come and see us.
All right, awesome. Come and see us.
You guys, really good tips, making me a little hungry for breakfast.
I know, we're hungry out here. I'm going to eat a little bit because I didn't want to eat on air while I'm talking to her.
There you go. All right, Sally's going to have a snack, and we're going to talk about the weather now. We'll also be out. A lot of our morning team, our afternoon and evening people here on Denver 7, will be out there at the expo today. So if you'd like to come by at Southwest Plaza, please come and say hello. We love to meet you guys. Now, here's the view from Loveland Ski Area. Talking about our forecast for today, that system brought some fresh snow to our high country. A lot of our ski resorts are saying, yay, we have at least a couple of inches of fresh powder on the ground for a lot of our skiers and snowboarders today. We're under partly cloudy sky in Denver, and temperatures right now in the low 20s. So it's a little bit chillier to start off this morning than what we felt the past couple of days. Wind sustained from the south at 14 miles per hour and will stay dry throughout the course of the afternoon. Here's our radar and satellite. Not too much going on. You see this layer of cloud coverage from Denver up north into Fort Collins, and then clear skies across I-70. So if you or someone you know are planning a trip to and from the mountains, it'll be dry throughout today. Now, temperatures outside elsewhere. Lakewood only at 17 degrees. If you do have morning plans here in the next couple of hours, definitely bundle up. We'll continue to see teens in low 20s through about 9 o'clock. Keensburg right now at 25 and Longmont 21, but the wind chill values making it feel even colder. Spots like Aspen feels like 7 below 0, so a really chilly start to our morning there. Steamboat in the single digits with teens to feels like values in the single digits across the plains. But hour by hour, as we head throughout much of the afternoon, we'll gradually climb to the low to mid 40s across most spots in the metro. 42 by about 3 o'clock. Winds not nearly as gusty as what we felt yesterday, and overnight lows won't be as cold as we head into Sunday as things start to get a little bit milder statewide. By 3 o'clock into Broomfield, 42 degrees, a little bit warmer into Littleton and Highlands Ranch at 46. These temperatures are really standard, right around average for this time in January. Here's our future cast. Statewide, as we go into the afternoon hours, we'll see a mostly clear sky in and around the Denver area. Then late tonight into early tomorrow morning, we'll start to see some snowfall. Places like Steamboat into Rocky Mountain National Park. Not talking about a lot of real measurable accumulation or heavy snow by any means, but still up into about 10 o'clock tomorrow morning, lingering snow showers mainly at higher elevations for our northern mountains. Down south of I-70 should stay mainly dry, clear, and then winds will pick up, especially across the plains tomorrow afternoon. Winds gusting in from the northwest as that system sort of skirts the northern half of Colorado. Late tomorrow night into Monday as well, it's going to get even warmer. Low temperatures for tonight, 25 degrees in Denver, single digits in teens in Aspen. It'll be really windy, especially at higher elevations. So if you are in the high country, goggles if you're skiing or snowboarding, of course, and also really bundle up, because tonight we'll get down to the 20s tomorrow, near 50 degrees out at DIA. So as we head into Monday and Tuesday, things will get even warmer. Mild, dry as we start this next week, 58 degrees, near 60 come Tuesday. And then our next best chance of a storm that we're tracking will be Wednesday into Thursday. Temperatures will cool down to the 40s to 30s with overnight lows in the teens and 20s. Sally?